Hi everyone, Matt Esser, deer biologist with the Wisconsin Department of Natural Resources. Today we're down with doing a site visit on a property in southern Monroe County for the Cooley Country branch of the Quality Deer Managers Association. I love working with these guys, super pumped about habitat management, managing their property for not only deer but also for the wildlife populations, and it's going to be a great day. I think we have about 35 people scheduled for the tour, and stay tuned, you're going to see a lot of cool videos as we walk around and habitat management techniques, and stay with us. And he's like, you know, pumpkins or gourds or something like that. I'm like, yeah, that's a possibility. You could definitely mix those into your seed. I would just throw a smorgasbord down in here, and what I would throw in is more of that winter type stuff, you know, rape and turnips. Pile driver radish is a huge fan. I'm a huge fan of right now. It works up the soil and, you know, leaves a lot of vegetative matter and green manure, so to speak, that you can work up in the future. The next spring, and just go in like this spring, I would have came in and worked it up, and I probably would put in just wheat or oats. And then, you know, once it's time to plant that winter stuff or that late season stuff, say July, then you can just come in and work that green manure right back into the ground and broadcast it over, and away you go. So I always like to have something for the spring and then if you put winter wheat in with that mix, next spring you won't have to plant because that stuff will come back and it'll be green and give something for those deer to eat in that critical time period of March, April, and May. Spot right here is designated for the timber harvest. You know, you have a lot of white oaks in here, and then you have a lot of what we call advanced regeneration. See these guys? These are all oak. But if you can't see all this stuff? If you can see it, that's all browse. That's all browsing pressure from white-tailed deer. This tree probably should be here. You know, look at this. Look at this other species that's not as palatable, right? It's nipped here, but look at how tall it is. And you have all your oaks in here. Every single one of them, if you come down here and walk through as we go around, every single one of these is nipped. And it'll continue to be nipped until it reaches eye level, right? Then it's out of the range of the deer to eat it. But if you look, every single one of these. Mm-hmm. Now, if it's only 20-30%, we can handle that, right? But if we start coming in here as managers and we're looking at 80-90% of these are browse, we don't really want that because they're never gonna grow. This tree is old as heck. I call it bonsai oak. You know, look at how thick and nasty and you know, the base is that big, you know. This tree probably should be super tall. And that's what Randy's going to do. He's going to take off the ceiling, so to speak, take off the roof, and allow this stuff to just proliferate and grow. And there's going to be a lot of other seed source in here that's going to germinate and grow too. So this is a really cool spot. And it's going to pay off dividends. You got, I think, doesn't it go from that road down to that road?
Yeah.
So, I mean, look what you just created. You just created travel corridors. You're going to create dense cover. And on a staging area going up into the food source, and you're going to have all these areas that are going to be good. This stand's going to continue. This is all white oak, right? So white oak's key. We love white oak. You know, deer, one of the preferred acorns is for the deer is white oak. So anytime we can manage it, it's great. And then you can see over there, see all that? Those saplings are taller. They're out of the reach now. So now they're going to continue to grow. So that's cool. And if you look, there's a little bit bigger of an opening, right? The sunlight shining down in there a little bit more. And that's what you really want. Get that sunlight to the forest floor to stimulate that growth. Really get all this stuff to go. Here's a maple tree. This maple is browsed exactly like everything else. So, I mean, you're talking, you're going every single one. Here's a briar or a blackberry one. That's browsed. So everything's browsed in here, even down to this little guy. It's got ferns growing. Ferns are a good indicator of soil quality. You can kind of see the quality of the oak that was here in the past. Forestry management really, I don't know, it didn't start to take shape in the private lands like this in Wisconsin until 60s, you know, 70s. So, and during that time, they'd see this, and I still see it and go, man, I don't know if I want to carry cable and hand cut all that stuff up in there, you know, unless it's nice big stuff. So. What they used to do is take the big stuff and leave everything else. What that term is called high grading, right? They're taking the best and leaving the poorest quality. And it's expected for those trees to grow up, but what you're left with is a residual stand of not that great of timber, repopulating the rest of your woods for the time being. So an area like this, I always tell landowners, there's tons of areas that you could focus on your property. I don't recommend going into every single piece of your property and managing and harvesting everything at one time. So is this of high priority? Probably not, right? You can just buy the cabin. There's certain areas, there's aesthetic values that are coming into play. So here's an oak tree that obviously has survived and gone above the browsing pressure. And so right here along the edge. And as you can see, this tree is gonna be the next crop for this woods. And you know, as a landowner, you can come in and prune off this lower one. You can come in and cage it and at least tube it so a buck won't come in and rub on it. And this is gonna be, you know, this is vitally important, you know, for your next age class and your next stand of timber. And as you can see, there's a couple of them right here. So it's right here along this edge. They get a little filtered sunlight. You can come out and take out this black cherry, a couple of these maples to release this oak, and you'll have oak on your property. And what I told him, I said, in this area, you have this is just a natural travel corridor. Mm-hmm. You know, you have all this stuff coming together, and I would continue a planting somewhere out in here just to create that, continue that. Deer love linear things, and they'll follow them. This is an invasive. You guys, if you live in this country, take note of this, okay? And there's some here, and there's gonna be more on the other side, and it kind of grows in a clump like this. Well, I hope you enjoyed this video segment. It's a short example of what you can expect on a DMAP site visit that you can get with a wildlife biologist, a deer biologist like myself, and a forester. It's gonna give you some tangible, useful things that you can implement on your property, on the ground techniques. And we can actually show you and walk through with you those techniques as we're out on the property and give you specific recommendations. And that's what you can expect from the DMAP program. If you would like more information, go to our website and quick word search DMAP, and you can have all the information you need. Thank you again.